You guys asked a lot of actuary questions, so let's bang out some answers. If you want these actuary Q&As to happen more frequently, be sure to leave your questions in the comments down below. Let's go. How did you cope with stress and anxiety over your actuarial exams? I'll be honest, some days very poorly, lots of crying, I'm a crier. The things that I felt really helped me in terms of stress and anxiety were to one, give myself permission to take days off from studying. I think that's so key to just say, today I'm gonna de-stress, I'm gonna take a bubble bath, I'm gonna go to yoga, I'm gonna go to ballet, I'm gonna do whatever it is that I wanna do that will take me and put me in a better mindset so that tomorrow I can just come at it clean. Complaining to people, I find complaining to be like my number one technique for dealing with stress. And also just knowing why I'm studying. Like, I always knew, all right, I'm doing this because I want to become an actuary. It sucks, but there's an end date and I hate my life right now, but soon my life will be better. And like, I'm done now. And let me tell you, is better. Do you have any advice on what students can do to learn about and stay up to date on what's going on in the actuarial industry? First thing I'd say is go on Actuarial Outpost. I know when I used it, I mostly just went to the exam forums, but there are general forums that you can sort of look at and see what people are talking about, what is the goss. The next thing you can do is, I know that everything I say is gonna be CAS-centric because I'm like, an FCAS, I'm a fellow of the Casualty Actuarial Society, no big deal. But when I was writing exams, I would get a magazine called Future Fellows that they put out specifically for people who are writing exams. And then they also have a few other free publications that you can look at on their website or subscribe to as well. I think there's one called Contingencies. Also, just reach out to your network if you have one. That's the best way. If you know people working in the industry, talk to them. If you know older students who've done internships, talk to them, just say, hey, what are people talking about at the office? Word of mouth is the best way to keep up to date with word of mouth? I don't know. Will I have a social life if I'm studying actuarial science? Did you have a social life before you started studying actuarial science? Because if you weren't a social person before, you probably won't be after. Personally, when I was studying for exams, my social life was but between exams, the people that I was in school with, the people that I was studying with, the people that I work with are some of the funnest people that I know. I don't know why people think actuaries are weird or socially awkward. I mean, we are like socially awkward, but we're fun socially awkward. I literally just came back from hot yoga. I'm still in my sweaty yoga bra. But I just was like, I haven't filmed in so long. We're filming. I don't care. But I'm in a bit of a like yoga high right now, so forgive me. Would you recommend to someone who is not interested in actually becoming an actuary, but has the knowledge to pass exams, to just take the exams for the experience? No! No! The exams are awful. Like, it's so stressful. I mean, if you want to do it, YOLO, but I don't know what value it's gonna add to your life. If you don't want to work as an actuary, non-actuarial hiring companies don't really care if you pass that actuarial exam. Do actuaries get to travel a lot? I personally don't travel much for work except for maybe jumping from Montreal to Toronto and vice versa, just because most of the actuaries in our company work in one of those two cities, so sometimes we like bounce over just to have like a let's hang out and do actual work in the same place event. Now that I'm done my actuarial exams, I do plan to go to conferences at least once a year, and there will be travel involved in that. What does an actuary's physical workspace look like? So I can't speak for all actuaries, but for me, I work in a cubicle. It looks like a cubicle. It's a cubicle farm, a floor full of cubicles. My manager is in a cubicle, his manager is in a cubicle. We're doing the whole like open concept cubicle-y thing going on. It's all right. I do have a laptop, so I can take my laptop home and work from home if I want to, but I choose not to. I do have coworkers who work from home like 2 or 3 days a week. How much coding do you do as an actuary, and how complex is the code that you write? I don't think that the code that I write is particularly complex. I mean, it's more than basic, but not like crazy algorithms. It's a bunch of, you know, ifs and mini loops. I would say, how much do I do depends on the project. There can be weeks where I'm coding 100% of my week, and there can be weeks where I'm doing everything in Excel, which I guess you could call Excel coding, but like I don't. I call the coding that I do is in SAS and VBA, and I will eventually learn R. For me, it's a good chunk of my time. For my boyfriend, who's also an actuary, who works for a life insurance company, very little of his time is spent coding. If you're not into coding, I would not recommend PNC, because coding is where it's at in PNC. I mean, you can do other things, but like, it's fun. Big thumbs up if you want more Q&As, more actuary questions answered. Subscribe to see more of my face. Thank you for calling. Bye.